My name is Mizuki Morita from Okayama University in Japan. I'm currently working in a biobank in our university hospital. A biobank is collecting blood, tissue, urine, and other biospecimens from patients in our hospital. But today I will not talk about how to collect and process blood or saliva, but I will talk about how to collect and process clinical text in Japanese in EHR and how to put them into shared task. Previously, I was involved in one of the shared tasks called NTCIR, which is hosted by National Institute of Informatics in Japan. I proposed to start MedNLP task to NTCIR committee, and I was one of the organizers of MedNLP tasks from 2012 to 2017. This is a part of discharge summary of a patient in Japanese. What we want to do in these tasks was to improve the techniques to process clinical text in EHR. And in NTCIR 10 MedNLP, there are two subtasks. One is the identification task, and another is extracting complaint and diagnosis task. The participants try to extract time and place representation in green color, and complaint and diagnosis in red color. And next, in NTCIR 11 MedNLP 2, there are also two subtasks, extracting complaint and diagnosis task again, and normalizing complaint and diagnosis. The participants try to extract complaint diagnosis, and then they try to assign proper ICD-10 codes to the terms. And third, in NCRR 12, MedNLP doc, there was one subtask, ICD-10 coding task. In a day, the participants extract the terms about the disease or symptoms. And then they apply one ICD-10 code to this text. And in these shared tasks, we had two major problems. First one is the number of clinical texts. In NTCIR 10, we used only 50 texts. And even in NTCIR 12, we had only 200 texts. And finally, in NTCIR 13, we gave up to increase clinical text, and we used Twitter text related to disease symptom. And the second problem is the origin of clinical text. Because it is very difficult to collect and distribute the clinical text in EHR, so we used dummy text and national exam data. These texts are not actual clinical text, of course. So here is one possibility to overcome the problems. I'm currently collaborating with a hospital organization in Japan. There are 142 hospitals throughout Japan within this organization. They have a central clinical data archive for research purpose. That includes clinical data from hospitals within this organization. So if we can properly use this data in shared tasks, we would be able to overcome the problems I mentioned before. To realize it, we need to persuade the president of this hospital organization to use it in shared tasks. So the goal of this week in Bra 5 for me is to make a proposal to the president of the organization to bring cooperation to future shared tasks, which includes the proposal includes a strategy to safely use patients' clinical text in EHR. And here are constrained conditions. One is only limited administrative staff can access the archive, the data. Then only they can perform anonymization. We cannot. And the second is concerns of the president and the staff in the organization are patient privacy and their effort and the cost. So the proposal of me should be easy understandable to them, and taking account the rigid privacy protection and as less effort and cost as possible. Here are examples of the strategy. First is to anonymize clinical text by the administrative staff and provide them to participants of the shared task. Maybe we cannot do it. And second is to bring tools which are submitted to the shared task to the administrative staff for evaluating tools. The staff to use these tools. And third strategy is to provide virtual environments to the participants of the shared task to develop and test their tools. We need to put the clinical text of the organization to this environment. So none of them are perfect. So I will brush up or find out the alternative strategy. Yeah, thank you for your attention.